What's up YouTube, welcome back to my channel. I am Beauty Lux and today we are going to be creating this beautiful emerald green look with Drugstore Cosmetics. That's right, you've heard me correctly. We are using Drugstore Cosmetics because guess what, that's where I came from. I'm from the hood, so you know, hey, we used to be in the drugstore and the beauty supply store. That's what we did, and I created this beautiful look with all of those products. And it's a lot of products that you guys may know and a lot of brands that you may know. So if you want to see how I got this beautiful look, keep watching. Seeing you got ritualistic, cleansing my soul of addiction for now. Okay, I'm back, y'all. Like I said, I was. So today's video is going to be on Drugstore Cosmetics. Yes, we are going to create a beautiful emerald green look using Drugstore Cosmetics. This video is dear to me just because that's where I came from. I used to buy a lot of my makeup from the beauty supply store and drugstores before I got into doing makeup professionally from department stores or just like knowing about different brands and things like that. This is where I used to get most of my stuff from. So yeah, this is gonna be fun. I had to dig in the crates for some of my stuff because, you know, we don't throw things away just because they will discontinue something in a minute. And I added a couple of new things here as well that I wanted to try out also, so that'll work for me. So let's get started. I did put some concealer on my eyes already, which I might have to do over and set it with powder because I see it's creasing already. And I did do my brows already, y'all know that. If you guys want to see a video about how I do my brows, leave it in the comment section below and I will get that video out to you guys. But I will let you know what I used on my brows. I use the NYX, let me get that, the NYX eyebrow gel, and this is in the color Espresso. Sorry, gonna get focused again. Sorry guys. I'll use that one and I'll use the Kat Von D just because they're waterproof, so they don't move around for me. Again, my skin is oily, so I like to use waterproof products. And then what else do I use? I think that's it right now because pencil just don't do it for me at all. Like, they just move all around on my eyebrows and I don't like it at all. Y'all remember when NYX used to be in just the beauty supply store? That was such a time. Yeah, they used to be in the beauty supply store, and that's why I was so surprised when they opened the store. I was like, oh wow. And then I was fortunate enough to work for them when they did open the stores, and it was a wonderful experience. And yeah, it was just great. I love NYX to this day. Like, they have some bomb products and they just continue to be innovative, and they always creating new stuff and they always on top of their game. That's why they still here and that's why they still winning. So shout out to NYX. Okay, so I did my eyes and I did put some concealer on it, but it looks like it's creasing. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go over with this brush and then I'm going to go ahead over it with my translucent powder so it doesn't move around, because that's the only way it's not going to move around, because the way my face and this oil is set up, bye. So I'm just going to use my Maybelline Fit Me Loose Finish Foundation Powder. No, finishing powder, I'm sorry, finishing powder, and this is in the color medium number 25, and I'm just using that for to set my lids. But other than that, this powder is bomb.com, just so y'all know. This is one of the best powders on the market, but my favorite, I'm gonna let y'all see my favorite in a minute. Once I get to that part, I'm gonna show y'all my favorite powder of all times. It stands the test of time. It stands with the Laura Mercier's, the Hourglass, the Sasha Buttercup. It stands there for me. That's me. This is just my opinion. Some people could use it and don't like it or whatever, but for me, that was it for me when I got my eyes on that one. Yeah. Okay. So let's get into these eyes. So I have two different palettes here. I have this MILANI GILDED TERRA palette, which is a very pretty palette. It looks like this. And then it looks like this in the inside. These are all those beautiful colors. You see those greens and those purples and those golds. And I just like it. As you can see, I tore that color up. Right up my alley. It's a gold, so I love it. Wear that all the time. And then I have this LA Girl Hey Hey Vacation palette, which is a very pretty palette. I was surprised. Not surprised, because LA Girl always coming through with some drip. But yeah. And I always keep the glasses on. I don't know why, like that's saving something. But this is the LA Girl. This is the palette. It has some greens in there, some golds,
some oranges. I don't know if you can see how pretty those colors are, but they are very, 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 very pretty. Very pretty. And so I think I'm going to go in with the Milani palette, the Gilded palette to start off. Wait a minute, because I think the LA girl got the brown in it that I need to use for my transition. And it does. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to do this. Okay. So I'm going in with this color right here. It's like a peachy, like brownie kind of color. I'm just going in with my crease. Just a little bit with that. Yeah. These are, the pigment on these palettes are amazing. They don't cost a lot. This palette, I think, was... I'm not going to lie to you. I think I paid $13.99 for it, but it could be $17.99 now. I saw it in Ulta, and I forgot what price it was in Ulta. I think it was like $17.99 now, but when I bought it, it was like $13 or something like that. And, yeah. LA Girl is another one that I used to use a lot of. I don't know if anybody remembers when they used to have the, like... that skinny palette. It was like a skinny palette and it had like 5 or 6 colors in it. I used to buy all of them because they were like $1.99 or something like that. So I used to buy all of them and just have them, all those colors, and not do nothing with them, just look at them, because I just like to collect stuff and just be a hoarder. And I used to just collect all of that stuff, and the only one I used to wear was the pink one and the gold one, because I love pinks and gold. So the only thing I used to wear was the pink one and the gold one, and it was just pointless. I remember when I used to work at Nick's, she's one of my best friends now. She used to be like, why are you buying all this makeup and you know good and well you're not gonna wear it? You do not wear none of this makeup. And I was like, because I just gotta have it. It just needs to be in my vicinity. I just need to see it. See it. Okay, so now I'm gonna go in with this brown color right here in the Gilded palette. And I'm just gonna go right in the corners with that. And just blend that out. Just a little bit. So you guys can see me. It's me, Sarah. So yeah. I like color. I like to look at colors. I like the way that they look, and I like when to see them on other people, and I like to put them on other people. But I could look at somebody and be like, yeah, they don't need all that color. They don't need all those colors. Like, red is my color. That's my color. You see me, you can always see me in red. Red I'm gonna always be. If I go out, then I'll do like this green look or something like that if it requires it. But other than that, my look is always neutral. Not saying that I won't try something. I will definitely try something. Like if I go on vacation or something, I'll do like pretty pinks and stuff like that. And I'll do a pink. I will definitely do a pink. But when they start getting to blues and bright oranges and all that stuff, I'll be like, nah, I'm not doing all of that. And it's fun to do it, you know, on camera or whatever, and some people just look really, really amazing in those colors. But for me, that's just not my style. And that's not something that I'm interested in, because I have big eyes. But just because you have the lid space doesn't mean you need to fill it up. And that's for sure, because I see people do that all the time. They will fill their lid space up with some shadow. And I'll be like, why do you... That's like, when I... Before, like, earlier in, like, the 2000s. Earlier in the 2000s, like, 2010 and stuff. When I used to see the girls get their makeup done in Atlanta. Oh, my God. It used to look like they took a whole quad and put it on one eye and then get another one and put it on the other eye. And it's like, why they got so much eyeshadow on? But that was the thing back then. It just was a thing. You know? So... Okay, so now we're going to go in... Oh, this green is so pretty. We're going to go in with that green right there. Where is it? Right here. I'm sorry, y'all. I always do that because I can't see from back here. So this right here, I'm going to go in with that green all over my lid. Super pretty. Oh. I was about to start singing Uncle Charlie. Look at her. Look how pretty that is. Oh, man. Oh, I miss wearing green. So pretty. And so, yeah. Tell me what some of y'all favorite drugstore cosmetics down at the bottom, because I know everybody got a... One of my favorite brands from the drugstore is going to be, hands down, Maybelline. Maybelline just be attacking people. Like, they just be attacking the other brands. Like, oh, y'all sleeping? All right, here we go. Like, they go off when they have to. That's one of my favorite brands. That was one of my... Trust me, when I only used to buy beauty supply, they people be like, oh my God, who did your makeup? Where you get your makeup? I was like, this is Maybelline. I used to be saying this is Maybelline like I was saying this is Chanel. This is Maybelline. And they're looking at me like, bitch, Maybelline, get out of here. You sound stupid. Going crazy for Maybelline. But yep, I love Maybelline. And I used to be heavy on CoverGirl because Brandy was representing CoverGirl. And that's my girl. She was a CoverGirl. Like, she was one of the first black CoverGirls. I think her and Tyra Banks. One of the first black CoverGirls. And I was like, Brandy wear CoverGirl? I'm about to wear CoverGirl. Tweet. That's it. We don't want to hear nothing else. CoverGirl it is. So, I like CoverGirl as well, but I stepped away from CoverGirl just a little bit, just because, I don't know, sometimes they stuff just be looking real blah. And then sometimes they have some stuff and you be like, oh, okay, that's cool. I'm going back in with this orange color just to blend out. Just to blend out on the top. Okay. And now I'm going to go back in with that brown just in the corners. And just right here, just to darken it up just a little bit. Just to smoke it just a little bit, not too crazy. Like dark eyes like that. Yeah, I mean, if anybody knows me, they know. Well, mostly I probably want them, but you know me, I've never worn a smoky eye. That's just not. Only time I wanted to wear a smoky eye is when I seen A. Marie do that video. Why are you the only one that I care about? That's when I wanted a smoky eye. She looked so bomb. I was like, oh my God, that's my girl, yo, A. Marie. I love her. I still be pumping her music to this day, but yeah. So yeah, and I'm gonna go back over the green once again once we get everything else finished. And so yeah, okay, so I did my the shadow is all done. Let's get into some mascara on my lashes, just because I like to put a little bit of mascara on my lashes before I put on my actual lashes. I don't do eyeliner just because my eyes are big and I don't like the way it looks on me. And sometimes I will try it sometimes, but you know, whatever. So I discovered this one day. I was just buying a bunch of stuff from beauty supply store, and I discovered this. This is the Ruby Kiss Multifunctional Mascara, and it's in black. Okay, so fun fact, this mascara, let me just get zoomed in for you. Okay, this mascara right here is an exact duplicate to the Gucci mascara, and I just wanted to let y'all know that. This is a duplicate for this. This is $40, this is $2. You do the math, okay? That's it. And then I have my good old, it's so funny, I'm seeing everybody going crazy about this mascara right here. And I've been using this for so long. And this one as well from Essence. Essence has some really bomb pieces too. And I've been using this one. And this is like the $4.99 a piece. And I'm just like, oh, okay. People going wild. But this one, I'm going to use this one. And this is, I think it's $1.99 or $2.99. Something like that. And it's equivalent to the Gucci, I'm just saying. Length, everything. It doesn't dry out, no nothing. And if you put, like, I just put one coat, but if you put like two or three coats of this on, sheesh, because I'll be putting on two or three coats when I don't wear lashes. I stack up on my mascara, and then I put my mascara on and I comb through it so it doesn't have any clumps or anything like that. Keep going just like that, like three times, and it'd be bomb. And so I'm going in with my Iconic Light House of Lashes. Yeah, I love these lashes. So these are some of my favorite lashes. I'm gonna go in with these. I am gonna do my lashes on camera just because somebody requested, and I feel special that I show them how I do my lashes. So this is gonna be quick and easy. I just like to go, I like to get as close to my lash line as possible, so that way, because I don't use liner, you can't really see the lash line. So I do everything with my fingers first, and then I get my I'll get my tweezer and like push it into my lash line. And some people like to make sure that their lashes are not as wet. You want to make sure it's sticky. I don't have patience, so I just put it on and I let it dry while I do the rest of my face. And it does. It dries. So I just take this, and hopefully you can see. I take this and I get really, really close to my lash line. And then I take and just move them over just a tad bit. And this is when I'm gonna grab my tweezers and I'm gonna go really close to my lash line with the tweezers and the lash, just to push them in to make sure they're secure in there. And that's it. And then that way I don't have, like, you know how sometimes people have glue all over the place, I mean bottom lash, top lash, hands, everything. I don't have any glue all over the place like that, so it's easy for me. And it literally takes me like a second to just pop these in and just keep them moving. So yeah. And while you're doing one lash, you can put the glue on the other lash and let that be drying and get sticky while you're doing one lash, so that way you don't have to do what I'm doing right here. But I'm doing this just for purposes of showing people how to actually put their lashes on. Wiggle it. I just fan it just a second, just to get, you know, just to get it a little sticky. And then where's my, oh, look at that. Wait, what's happening there? My arm is wiggling. Y'all, I weigh like 125 pounds. What's happening here? Yes, I'm toning up. So, yeah, I get as close as I can. Get that in there. Get that right to the lash line. And then we're just going to press this in. Oh, sorry. Make sure we get it. And then we're just going to press these into the... press that into the lash line, and we are set. And our lashes are on. And they go on so fast, and it literally don't take me no time to do my lashes. Except for, like, sometimes when I'm going out and my lashes know I'm going out and they want to give me a hard time, then it'll be different. Then it start acting all crazy and stuff. And then, why is this doing this? Hold on. But anyway, I'll fix that once we, you know, do everything else. Okay. So, lashes are done. Now, this is where it gets a little bit faster and easier. So now, I am going to be using the Power Grip Primer from E.L.F. I was only able to find this little one right here. I was trying to look for the big one. It's sold out everywhere. So hopefully, I got to go out tomorrow. Hopefully, I can find it in one of the Ulta's or something like that. Because this is not enough. It's supposed to be a dupe. It's like a dupe. Not supposed to be. But it's like a dupe to the Milk Cosmetics one. And not for nothing, it's very similar. So E.L.F. did it. They did the damn thing with this one. So I'm going to use a little bit of this. It's not sticky or anything. It's just like, it's literally just like that. I don't even know how they did this, but it's a good primer. I've used it before. And so I was only able to find this little one. It was $5. And hopefully I can find a big one, because I actually would really like a big one. Because I think I'll use this, because it's kind of like a water-based primer. So that works for me. Ooh, that works for me. So now with foundation, I've been using I like this. I like the concealer. I like everything about all of them. This one is the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Perfector 4-in-1 Glow. I like this because it's like a concealer. I mean, it's like a foundation, but it has all of this other stuff in it as well. And so I ran out of it, the one that I did have. And so now I got a new one. So I'm twisting it to come up. Hold on. It's coming. Oh, there we go. Okay. Yep. Sorry, I ain't gonna be doing that. So I just do a little here. Here. And it's lightweight, it's not too heavy on the skin. This one is in the color medium, just because the 3 would have been way too dark. And I don't know if y'all have ever seen this spray. It's the Pearl Essence Brightening Pineapple Enzyme Facial Tonic. They sell these in they'll have them in like TJ Maxx or trying to get focused for you guys. If you guys have any suggestions on cameras also, please let me know, because this camera is just driving me up the wall. I don't even know. Like, I'm just sick of it. They sell these at like TJ Maxx and stuff like that. I love this spray. I had the Calm and Vanilla, Lavender one. And then they had like a cucumber one. Like that one too. And this just goes right into your skin. Like, it's like skin. Like, it's literally like skin. And it's buildable. Like, you could keep building it until you get the coverage that you want. So, yep. I love this. This is good for people who don't like a ton of makeup like me. And it has a highlight in it. It's like it got everything in it. So, it's a 4-in-1. So let me tell y'all what the 4-in-1 is. It's a 4-in-1. So I can't see. So it's a concealer, foundation, highlighter, a BB cream. Stop playing with Maybelline, all right? Because they're trying to stay on the innovative side. Yes, it's buildable. You can build it up if you want to. I like this. I like this is enough coverage for me. So yes, this will work for me. Okay, so now we're gonna go in with the concealer, my Maybelline concealer. I use that in caramel, which is now $4.40, I think it is the number. They were sold out because I thought I had one in storage, but I didn't. They were sold out, but I was able to get my hands on the new Makeup Revolution IRL Filter Finish concealer. And this is in the color C12. And I actually like it. It's like a pinkish kind of undertone to it, but it covers well. It covers really well, to be honest with you. And yeah. So the foundation, I have the foundation. I found this with the foundation. The foundation was in the F12. That wasn't it for me. That wasn't it. Wasn't even gonna do nothing for me. So I'm gonna go in with, not my beauty blender today, but I'm going in with my e.l.f. sponge. I like the sponge a lot. I'm going in with my e.l.f. sponge. I'm just gonna blend this out. And again, I really like this concealer. And this is a matte concealer. And I'm not really a matte concealer girl, but this is a matte concealer and it goes on really nicely. So I was happy about that. I don't know if y'all can hear those kids outside playing, but they should be. Oh, I just look at the time. It's 8:14. I'm like, they should be in the bed, but they should be in the house because it's Monday and they should be in school tomorrow. So, I don't understand why they outside making noise at 8 o'clock. And I mean full-fledged playing football and tag and all this other stuff at 8 o'clock. And so, sometimes this stuff be confusing me because sometimes it could look ashy and sometimes it don't have to look ashy. But right now it's looking ashy, but I'm going to warm it up, so it's fine. I don't know why it's looking ashy right now, but I'm about to warm it up. I'm using, for my contour, I'm going to be using something that they don't make anymore. So I'm glad about that because I couldn't find a contour in the drugstore and I didn't have one in my collection that was from the drugstore. But this is, just to give you a little backstory, this is Bite Cosmetics used to make these sticks and they are like these contour, it's not even a contour stick, it's a multi-purpose stick, but this one is the color cocoa. And I had like, when they discontinued them, I bought like most of them. And so I absolutely love this stick. Like, it's just like it gives the perfect blend out. So I'm just gonna blend this out and it's gonna warm me up to match, you know, the rest of this foundation, just in case, you know. And so, I was watching, what you call that again? What's Love Got to Do with It? For the 19th 00 zing zing time. And I get pissed off every time I realize that Angela Bassett did not get an Oscar for that. That's number one. I get pissed off with that. And then number two, I be forgetting how funny Ike was. I'm sorry, y'all. And I know abuse is not, it's not tolerable for any woman. Nobody should be doing that. But the stuff that he used to say to her was like, what is wrong with you? Like, how mental can you possibly be? This man told her, if you die, I'm gonna kill you. Like, what, sir? Are you, like, you gotta be. That's equivalent to Lucius Lyon saying that if he die, he gonna go and he gonna kill Jesus. I was like, okay, like, this script is, like, next level. Like, just don't understand it. But yeah, Ike was, the stuff he used to say was like, my lord, sir, you hate her that bad, just stay away from her. But she was his moneymaker, so he couldn't. But anyway, I was watching the other night and I was just like, Ike is, he's a wild boy. Like, that man was something else. Like, I don't know, I was just like, I don't know how she stayed that long with, you know. But everybody goes through things differently and they handle things differently, so, you know. But I be trying not to laugh. And then, you know what, the first time I seen What's Love Got to Do with It was when I was in the sixth grade. I didn't have no business seeing that movie. My teacher did not want to do his job, so he pulled the TV in there and was like, yeah, come on, y'all could, what's on my nose? Oh, he's like, come on, he's like, we're gonna do movie time. So we like, yeah, we can watch a movie, okay, cool. That man put on What's Up. We was like, what's this? They was like, what's up? Everybody started getting all happy and cheering because their parents wouldn't allow them to see it at home either, because they was like, it was some explicit stuff in here. And Ike telling her she a sorry bee and all this other stuff. I'm like, yo, what is this? So when I came home, I was like, mommy, I saw What's Love Got to Do it. It was so good. My mother was like, who showed you that? And I was like, my teacher. She was like, yeah. Why they showing y'all that in school? I was like, listen, it was a good movie. It was a good piece, okay? But yeah, that's one of my favorite movies of all time. Anyway, I'm just babbling about What's Love Got to Do it. I just watched it the other day and Ike was out of his mind. I just couldn't see nothing else. Anyway, I'm going in now, y'all. I promise you, this is one of my favorite finishing powders of all time. Black Opal. Bam. Black Opal, this is invisible. This is the neutral light soft velvet finishing powder, and this is in the color 200. This is equivalent to Laura Mercier. This is equivalent to Buttercup. This is the Sasha Buttercup. This is equivalent to Hourglass. This is one of the best finishing powders I've ever used in my life, period, point blank. They have multiple colors. Try it out for yourself, and it's $10. It's not $40, it's $10. I love this finishing powder. It is so good. It's like this, it's perfect for me because it has like this pink. I don't know why I did that, y'all. I slapped all this powder to the top of this thing. It has like this pinky tone to it, so it's very, very pretty. And it doesn't like sit on your skin and just, it doesn't do like, there's no, you know how you use some of the powders and it be, yellow, like you could see that the girl's face is yellow. Hate that. Oh my god, I hate that so much. I'm just like, I don't feel like you should see your makeup. I feel like it should be done and people should be like, oh my god, like your skin looks so good, like your makeup looks so good, like what do you use? Not yet, she beat. And we see all of the highlight and everything as soon as the camera flash. I hate that. So blending is a big deal for me. Like, you gotta blend. If you don't blend, you gotta blend. If you don't do nothing else, please blend. Blend, 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 blend. I love a good blend. I'm gonna be going over my stick, because you know I love cream and I love powder. I'm going over my cream contour with my Morphe Brontour. It's a bronzer and a contour. And this is in Showmance. I don't even know if Morphe makes this anymore, but anyway, I'll have everything down in the description box. I absolutely love this duet. It is a bronzer and a highlighter. And I use the bronzer over this, and it is perfect. And it gives you a beautiful, stunning look to the skin. Some makeup I stopped using because I used to do the routine. I used to use the routine at a certain time in my life, and it brings me back to that. It makes me remember sometimes, and then I'll get sad, and I don't want to use it anymore because I'm like, oh, I was using that when this was happening. And that. So I just stopped using it, but I'm okay now, so I could use it. It's like that with music, like everything. I'm like, oh, I remember when this happened, and I was doing this with this. And so I'll stop. And again, like I told you, I like to bring my contour up to my brows, underneath my brows, because it makes it look more realistic. Okay, so I'm just going to take a tip of my concealer and go back down my nose one more again, just a little bit. We're going to blend that out just to even out my contour. And I have it look so, oh. Oh, that's the powder. I'm like, what? Like I said, blending is key. I absolutely have to be blended out, or it just ain't gonna work for me. And so, yeah, y'all let me know, and let me know what stores do y'all go to shop for y'all beauty supply. For y'all beauty supply. For y'all cosmetics. Because there you can get cosmetics from everywhere now. You can get cosmetics from Walmart. You can get it from everywhere now. So that's a cool thing. So I want to know, because maybe it's some places I'm missing out. Anybody know me, know I love to shop. Especially when it comes to cosmetics. Honey, I can shop all day on that. You give me $1 million, I'll spend $500,000 on it in 2 hours. The streets will be ours. Okay? I will tear it up. You give me $5,000 for the makeup. I'm going to tear it up and buy everything in the world. I'm taking flights, all that. So I can go to the Walmart, Hong Kong. To be everywhere. I want everything. Okay, so I'm going to dust this powder off with. And I know this is a foundation. This is a hybrid powder foundation, but I'm going to use it real lightly. This is the new Super Stay 24-hour powder, and it's in the number 332. If I'm not mistaken, it's 332. This is the color that I got. The rest of them was so dark. I was like, what is this? But again, when you live in certain neighborhoods, they go by the geographic of who lives there. They'll send certain things. So they sent a lot of darker colors than they did that in between. Or they sent for what? There's really no white people over here. I don't even know why they be playing with us like that. But They do have like different demographics. It's like if I go to a Dwayne Reed or a Walgreens in the city, yeah, it's going to be mostly demographic. It's going to be mostly directed towards white women, and yeah, that doesn't work for me. So when I come over here and y'all only got this color and the rest of them is dark colors, I'm pissed off. So we're gonna see what this does, because I just want to dust this off and see how it's a foundation powder anyway. I just want to see what it looks like on top of this, because this foundation is so lightweight. I can get away with putting a little bit of powder on top. So let's see. And I'm gonna use my what brush is this? It's supposed to be a blush brush, but whatever. We're gonna use it for the powder. And I'm just gonna dust this off with this. And just because I want to see what the color look like. Okay, it's not bad. It's not bad. It's giving the very much. I've seen people put it on and look like cream. So I was I'm confused. Maybe I don't have the right one. I mean, regardless, I'm going to find it. But I think this is it. But I'm not sure. But it looks good. The powder looks good. I mean, I'm not complaining about the powder. Powder looks good. Okay, so now I did that. I'm gonna go in with my black NYX liner, and I don't use eyeliner at all at the bottom, but I'm gonna use it for this video because I have this green, so it requires a little bit of pizzazz to it. So I'm gonna use this green NYX pencil here. I mean the black. Oh, I think I have a green one. Hold on, please. Okay, I'm back. I did have a green pencil, so I got this green. It's tropical green. This is from NYX as well. It's a tropical green pencil. It's emerald green, just like this one. Just like my shadow or whatever. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the black pencil and I'm just going to put it right in here. Just a little bit in here. Because I like to do that sometimes. I don't know. It just gives it more of a sultry look. I just put a little on the inside. Gives it like a nice little sultry look. And then I take the green and I do it on the rest of the lid. Yeah. And it looks... Oh. I love green on me. I love green on me. I love red on me. I love pinks on me. Purple's my favorite color. You would think I would love it on me, make me like Pearl from 227. I hate it. And so now I'm just going to go in with a little bit of the mascara right at the bottom of my lashes. Yeah, this is one of my favorite go-to looks when I'm going out. Yes, honey, I love this eye. Oh my goodness, I love it. I'm gonna go over the green and my eyes on my eyes. Once I get to the end or whatever. Anyway, let's get to our highlight. So this is one of my favorite. When these came out, I would not stop using them. So this is the Hello Halo highlighters from Wet n Wild. Wet n Wild is one of my favorite brands as well. Oh my god, I remember what. Okay, so you know I love my cream shadow. I mean my cream highlights as well. So I'm gonna use this first, and then I'm gonna go in with a powder. And that's literally how I put it on. Oh my god, this is bringing back nostalgia. This is bringing back so many memories. You talking about lighting up a Cupid's bow, baby? Okay. I love these. I haven't looked for them because I literally have all of them and I don't need them. But I was wondering if they still even make these. Let me wet my beauty blender a little bit with my spray because it's a little dry. I'm wondering if they still make these. They are so beautiful. Oh my god, this just brought me back. Oh, look how pretty that is. Look how pretty that highlight is. I'm all about skin. I don't like highlight and glitter that sits on the skin. Drives me nuts. That's why I don't wear my, I have two of those Mariah Carey ones that from when she dropped her collection with MAC. I have two of them from there. I haven't worn them yet. I think I gave one to my niece. I ain't gonna hold you. I think I gave one to my niece. But look how pretty and highlighted that is. Look how gorgeous that is. It's just so pretty on the skin. You don't even need like a powder highlight after this. There's no need for it. And so I forgot to take this off. I broke my other one. So I had to go get another one. And I was able to. That's why I was able to find it. But I just recently saw that they made a whole entire collection to this. And this is the infamous Luminoso eyeshadow from Milani. I mean, blush from Milani, which I love. It was like, it's like the perfect peach. I think they had me in mind when they made this. It's like the perfect peach. Oh my god. So I'm just gonna a little of that. It's like the perfect peach for everybody. And then I also have this. Why is this? I hate that. When I open something and then I don't use it for a long time, then the sticker will go back on it and it'll be stuck on it. I'll be like, what's this? Okay, so I do have this Hello Halo. This is another one of the Hello Halo products from Wet n Wild, and this is in Flash Me. And it comes with, it looks like this. It comes with a highlighter and a blush, and it is very pretty. Extremely pretty. I'm just gonna add a little bit of that blush on top of this Luminoso, just because. Oh, there we go. Oh shit. Oh. I come apart. So yeah, I don't think I need to put the powder highlight on top of it. I don't need to do that at all. So yeah, no. So after this, then I'm gonna do my lip. Give me 1 second, I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. I just took off a little bit of that plumper that I have on my lips. I put that on all the time before I get started. And so as far as our lip goes, I'm gonna keep it really neutral because I have a lot going on in my eyes. And so I have, this is my LA Girl. Their pencils are so bomb. I love these pencils. And this color is in the color, what color is this? I hate that I can't, never mind. It just says GP. It's natural. This color is natural. And it looks like this. If you can see it, that's what the natural looks like. And then I have my good old, which one is this? This is the NYX Nude Truffle. And this is what this one looks like. This one is a little bit darker. I think I might go with the Nude Truffle just because it's a little bit browner. And I want to give this look, not too much, but just enough. And I like to just fill my lips with my pencil. Because I could just leave my lips like this and put a gloss on top and call it a day. With this eye. And so I have, actually love these. I have my butter gloss in Madeline and NYX, the butter glosses. I love these butter glosses. They are all that. Can you see it? Can you, is it focusing in on it? It did. So this is the butter gloss, and this is in the color Madeline. And okay, I'm focused. I'm just gonna go ahead and just gonna put this on. Very neutral look. I'm gonna go on top of it with my good old, you know it, dollar gloss, baby. This dollar gloss is just all that, I'm telling you. And it's in the flavor coconut, so. Look how it just make your lips look so nice and juicy. And all for a dollar. Because guess what? The dollar store, they're not slipping on you. They're not. I mean, the beauty supply and the drugstore, they're not going to slip on you. They're going to continuously give you the dollar stuff. And the dollar stuff works for us around here sometimes, you know. Yeah. So I'm going to go in with my E.L.F. Matte Magic spray. Everything will be linked below. And I'm just going to spray my face with this. Ooh, come on, E.L.F. She smells like hairspray, but you know. We gotta do what we gotta do. And okay, so this is the finished look. I hope you guys enjoyed this video because I enjoyed talking to you and while I was doing my face. I absolutely am obsessed with this look. I love greens on me, so this works. I encourage you to try it. If you don't try colors, I really, really encourage you to pick a color and try it. Just because for me working at the lip lab and so many women coming in and saying, I can't wear red, I can't wear red, I can't wear this, I can't wear that, I can't wear this. And then when I mix the colors together for them and I would make them their own personalized color, they started to realize that you just have to find what works for you. It may not be the same red that I wear. It may not be the same red that my sister wears. It may not be the same red that Kerry Washington wears, whoever. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter who it is. Everybody has different undertones. Everybody is going to see something different with their eyes. And I know, you know, some people like to tell you, oh, I don't wear that. I'm not going to wear that. I would never do that. And then they put it on and you tell them how beautiful they look and they still don't believe you. That's just their confidence level. I don't know what to tell them after that. But yeah, just try something. Pick a color, try it, because you want to step out of the box. This year we want to step out of the box. I'm not saying that the natural look is going to always be in, because that's all I do, but just try something different and see how you like it. This year we're just going to try a bunch of different stuff that we've never tried before. Just try something different and see where it takes you. I hope you guys enjoyed my video. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share my video with whoever, wherever. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Because like I said, we're building a community over here. And yeah, we're going to have some fun. So thank you guys again for watching my video. I appreciate you. Don't forget to give this a thumbs up if you did like it. And I will see you guys in the next video.